Hey, what's going on? So, wanted to address a question that I kind of feel you might be pondering if you've been kind of following along here lately. Now, I haven't been sending or doing as many trainings as I have done in the past, and it's been a little bit more intermittent. But if you've noticed, a lot of what it's been lately, it's been a lot more on the self-knowledge side of things, the inner game of marketing. And for the person that's kind of followed me as a marketing trainer and just a person that loves to learn about this craft, it's a stark contrast. I mean, if you go back a few years ago and you look at the sort of videos I would share and put together, it was always on here's a tweak you can make that's going to get you an extra 12% of conversion here. Or here's a tremendous breakthrough that I've had that changed the game for me. And I think it might change the game for you from a conversions, economic, hard money standpoint. And so the question's, why? Well, as I've just kind of sat back and relaxed as I've been working on some things that you'll see soon. It's given me the opportunity to really just think and reflect. And the truth is, why all this inner marketing stuff, self-knowledge stuff? Because ultimately, that's what marketing is. Everything that you want to create, everything that you imagine, everything that you want to build, it's not going to come from over here or, out there. It always starts in here. And so the more tuned you can become to how you move, how your thoughts go from one place to the next, and how that creates an emotion or an image in your mind, the better the marketer you're going to become on all levels. Really, what is marketing? It's a language. It's a language that's ultimately a conversation between two people, a person that has a problem and a person that has a solution. Now, the person with the problem is probably looking to have that problem solved, and the person with the solution needs to carry on the dialogue and ensure that the other party gets it, And as marketers, that's who we are. Ultimately, we're the person that says, "Hey, here's how I can help you." And if you're not, as a marketer, really thinking about and anticipating, if you say this, then what might they think? Either be positive or negative, rationally, logically, or emotionally. And you're just kind of doing something that's a process or rote. You're not doing what marketing is. Marketing is this. It's sort of dance. When I do this, then they react this way. So I've got to anticipate first before they even know it's going to happen. That's the art of marketing at the deepest of levels. And as I think back and recollect over all the things that have happened, that I've just loved, from little pieces of advice that I've given to people at the right time that have let them just go out and fulfill their dreams, or something that was a little tweak that turned out to be a big tweak. All these things started with something inside, right? It started with going all the way back to the beginning, failing, getting rejected on the phone, feeling demoralized, and at the same time being absolutely incapable of stopping, right? I would not stop until I would succeed. So when you're in that place, what do? You either keep bumping into a wall or you try something different. And for me, it was, here's the problem that I have. I can't do this way. So I need to be different. I want to be the person that can recruit without picking up the phone. That idea was the inspiration for me, not so much to create information products and teach and train people, but to fix a problem that I had at a very core level. I had no idea what it would turn into, but what I need you to see, what I want you to really get, is that all value, it's not a grandiose, it's not something to get nervous or and have anxiety about. It's you saying to yourself, here's something that I want to fix for me. And in doing so, what happens every single time is in sharing that, the value you got for you is just magnified exponentially. And I don't think enough marketers do that. I don't think enough people that begin their businesses. It's like we all have this, I don't want to call it a lack of confidence, but it's something in that area that, oh, I couldn't do that. I'm not that guy. None of us are that guy at the beginning or that gal at the beginning. The way that it begins is you say to yourself, here's something that I got to fix for me. And then instead of looking for something out there, you start to think and you say to yourself, what do I need to do to fix this for me? And that's the moment that your business really starts. That moment you start to think in that way is where this new sort of reality, this new level of perception and just ability, that's the seed, that's where it begins to grow. Just in fixing our own problems. And so the more attuned that you can become towards you and how you feel at certain times when you're frustrated or you're excited or you're interacting with content or marketing, that's the seeds of just abundance. Every little thing that I've figured out from things like the micro commitment lead capture page that it's just kind of sprung all across the internet to this whole idea of really selling without selling, the invisible funnel, just turning marketing inside out, really. Where does it come from? It comes from, wait, I think I'd feel better, or it makes a lot more sense, or when we look at things this way, we see that the problem isn't this, it's this. And that's all stuff that happens in here. And if you, it's always easier to look for the solution to anything outside, right? But if you do that, you won't ever get there. And so, why am I talking about all this inner stuff? Is because if I don't start this conversation kind of going for you, I'm not sure if or when it's going to happen. And I want it to. It's just what you think. It changes your life. I mean, that's all it is. It's communicating, not just through words like this, it's communicating on a little deeper level. and anticipating. Where in the regular world, we can do things and A plus B plus C equals something. It's a little bit more intuitive here, right? You've got to, right? Yeah, right there, and tweak, right? No one's going to tell you. That's the magic of this. It's that if you see that, if you get that, if you understand that, it means that there is absolutely nothing but air in the way from you creating whatever you want in your way, right? In maximum leverage, which we're going to bring it back. I had a lot of successful people come through as students there. As I look at each and every one of them, they're all very, very different people. They all do very, very different things. So don't ever think that what or who you become has to be like anything else or like anyone else. It will be you, your version. But that version doesn't start until the dialogue with yourself begins in a positive way, in a solution finding within way, not a, I wonder who has the answer to problem out here and pay way. They go together. Mentorship is absolutely critical. It shortens the learning curve, but it is not magic. You must be a thinking, feeling person. To be a marketer, and we all are. And so I can't let you miss the greatness you have right in front of you. And that's why, for all this inner self, inner marketing, self-knowledge stuff, it's important. Form, what it looks like, hey, it'll take you from an A to A plus. Substance, what it is, it gets you to the A. This is all the substance stuff. This is where it begins, and it's more than just marketing. It's a pathway to freedom. We start with this idea of, man, wouldn't it be great to get big checks? And that would be great. The freedom it would bring me would be just absolutely amazing. The sort of, I don't know, just not irony, but surprise of it all is that in getting there, you get this other thing that's so much more, which is to really be you in the most free way, with far more sight, much clearer mind, more intuitive. And just less fear. Life is good that way. And so the inner stuff is where it begins. So that's why, for all this stuff, it's not what's out there. If that's what you think it is, if you think it's a headline, if you think it's the right technology, the right autoresponder, the right whatever, it's your externally personifying what's necessary. It's the thing that we do when we have anxiety, when we don't want to believe here. But what I'm saying, and I've said it a couple times in a couple different ways, is that what's here, don't make it out to be more than it is. It's just you solving a problem for you first, and then sharing it. and then enjoying it and then saying, whoa, this is a good thing. What more can I learn? Coaching, right? That's where coaching, mentoring comes in. And then more doors get open. Things you didn't see that were right there are now right there, and you can touch them. And then it just cascades. Man, so I do have one question for you today before I end here. Think about this stuff deeply, and I want to challenge you with this is when you think about, share it with me. When you think about something you've done, a little insight, a little emotional resistance or positive feeling that you just used intuitively to change something and it made a difference. Man, what was it? Think about it, share it, and what you'll see is that we're not so different and that there's a lot of us that have these experiences, and it's that those things that we sometimes pass off as, oh, well, that was just maybe a little bit of luck, or oh, that's just what I do, it's not my business, I need to do this other thing, which that's another topic. Please share. Think about this. Share what you've experienced, first off, because I want to learn. I want to know. And I know that everyone else will too. And yeah, anyone that you know that you think would get anything out of this, please share. You know, I'm not selling anything these days in an aggressive way. So there's no loss. And they're not going to get bombarded with craziness, at least not for a little while. And that's it. That's it.